Last week I showed you how to use Canva's brand new animation features so that you could design quick marketing videos to share on social media. This week I want to take it one step further and show you how to use Canva's transitions. Transitions will help each page of your template change seamlessly from one to the next with really eye-catching effects. Canva launched a brand new transition, which some of you may not have even noticed, so I'm going to show you how to use that towards the end of the video. And keep watching because I'm going to be giving you a link which will give you a free upgrade to Canva Pro for a 45-day trial period rather than a standard 30-day period. Welcome and welcome back to my channel. My name is Nikki Pasquier and I help startups and small business owners use creative strategies to successfully market their brands online. And I only share the strategies that I use myself, so I know they work. If this is something you want to learn more about, you may want to subscribe to my channel and then click that little bell so that you get a notification when I publish a new video. Okay, so if you're ready to start learning about Canva transitions, follow me over to my Canva desktop. So here we are on my Canva homepage again, and you can use whatever template you want for this project. So it could be an Instagram post, an Instagram story, a Facebook post. But for the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to use the example I showed you earlier. So I'm just going to click on it to open it up onto my Canva desktop. Incidentally, if you missed this tutorial, I will leave a link to that in the description underneath so you can catch up a little bit later on. Let me just minimize this sidebar just so that we have a clean space. Okay, so I'm sure you're already aware that you can make quick social videos using templates with two or more pages. And as you can see from the thumbnails underneath this page, I have 5 pages. I've added photos, text overlays, and a few graphics, and then animated them using Canva's new animation features. Now, I could download this template as it already stands, but I wanted to set myself apart from my competitors and impress my target audience by adding some professional transitions in between each page. This ensured that they changed from one to the next smoothly, seamlessly, and incredibly professionally. So to start adding transitions, go down to your thumbnail images at the bottom of your page, hover your mouse over the first page that you want to add a transition to, and you'll see these three little dots appear. This means there's a hidden menu to explore. And if I click on the three little dots, I can see that from here, I can add a new page, duplicate a page, delete a page, and here we are, add a transition. So I'm going to click on that, and this brings up a menu of transitions in a column on the left hand side of my screen. Currently there are 5 transitions to choose from, including the latest one, which as you can see is still in beta. Each transition behaves slightly different, so hover your mouse over the thumbnail image to see what effect it has on your page. Once you've chosen your transition, click on it to open it up. One of my favorite transitions is dissolve, so I'm going to do just that, click on it. And underneath, I have the ability to customize the transition further by altering the duration. I can do this by holding my cursor over the little button here, holding my cursor down, and then sliding the little button along the slider bar. Alternatively, to change the duration, if you don't like the slider bar, you can just type it into this little box here. As I mentioned just now, each transition behaves slightly differently. So if you click on the slide transition, for example, you can see that I can set the duration of the transition, but I can also customize the direction in which the transition will appear. To see what effect that has on my page, I can just hover my mouse over the little thumbnail image. So I can have the transition appear from right to left, from left to right, from bottom to top, or top to bottom. with the circle wipe, if I click on it, I can select the duration of the animation, but I can also select the direction of the animation to appear inwards or outwards. So take just a moment to experiment and see what each transition does. I'm going to go back to dissolve and make sure that I've set the duration at 0.5 seconds. And here's a quick time-saving tip. If you want to apply this transition to all the pages in your template, all you need to do is go down to the bottom of this column on the left-hand side and click on Apply Between All Pages. And that's going to save you a lot of time if you're using templates with quite a few pages. To remove a transition, all you need to do is click on None. Okay, so far so good. Now for Canva's brand new transition. As you can see, this is still in beta, so it's still very new. If you click on the thumbnail, you'll see a brief explanation of what it does. So Match and Move animates identical elements smoothly between pages. And I've tried it out myself and it's great fun and really eye-catching. So using my template as an example, you can see that I've added a few floral elements on each page. Now I'm going to change my transition by selecting Match and Move. I'm going to apply it between all pages. I'm going to make sure the duration is set at about 0.5 seconds, that's about right. And now if I click on the play button at the top right hand corner of my Canva toolbar, you'll be able to see what effect this Match and Move transition has on my template. So the identical elements in my pages, so the floral elements, moved seamlessly to the next page, but in a slightly different position. I mentioned at the start of this video that you can use these transitions for presentations as well. So I've just opened this really good fun educational presentation for kids. I've set the transition to Match and Move. So I'm going to show you now what effect this has on this particular presentation template. I'm going to go up to the Present button. Make sure that the type of presentation is set to standard, and I'm going to click on Present. And watch what happens to the little elements that are shared between each page when I transition to the next page. Not only is this transition great fun, it will also help to hold your audience's attention because naturally we're attracted to things that move rather than static images. So let me know what you think. If you're considering testing out the new Match and Move transition, give me a thumbs up. Do make sure you watch last week's tutorial about Canva's animations. There are some brand new features that you may not be aware of. I'll leave the link to that video right here. And to benefit from a free Canva Pro upgrade for a 45-day trial period, just type this URL into your browsers. I will also leave it in the description box underneath. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.